Hello everyone, today we'll make pasta alla carbonara. This is a very important recipe for Italians, and we are very jealous of this recipe, and usually we really don't like when people change the ingredients. So this is the original carbonara with the real ingredients. If you change any of these ingredients, you can't call this pasta carbonara, it's something else. I'm not telling you that it's not gonna taste good, but you can't call it carbonara. You need to use these exact ingredients if you wanted to call it that name. So the ingredients are guanciale, this is the cheek of the pig. Never use bacon. So, guanciale. And the second most important ingredient is pecorino cheese, which is cheese made from sheep milk. Again, if you use cheese made from cow milk, you can't call it carbonara. Then we need black pepper, one egg yolk, just the yolk, not the white. And pasta, you can use whichever pasta you want. Usually we made spaghetti alla carbonara, but today I will use calamari because I have this leftover and I want to get rid of it. So you can change the pasta format, but you can't change the other ingredients. No garlic, no onion, no parsley. So just these very basic ingredients. So you might ask why Italians are offended when people change their pasta ingredients. This is because we Italians consider food as art. So this is a form of art for us. And if you change any of these ingredients, it's like changing the shape of Dalí clocks. So this is carbonara, and this is the only carbonara you can do. If you change anything, or if you add other thing, you need to change the name of the recipe. You can't call it carbonara. So let's start. We need to grind some pecorino cheese, as much as you want. This will be enough for me. Butter, again, there is not an exact proportion, you just do whatever you wish. And then we need to cut the guanciale in small pieces. Once we've cut the guanciale, we fry it in a pan until it's very crunchy. Then you put some water on the fire and some salt. Not much because pecorino cheese is very salty. And we wait until the water boils. In the meantime, we take the egg yolk, we put in some butter. And the pecorino cheese. And we start stirring until we obtain a cream. When the egg, the cheese and the butter are turned into a cream, you add the black pepper and again as much as you want. Water is boiling, you put in the pasta. The guanciale is now very crunchy, so we can stop the fire. So the pasta now is cooked, so we need to drain the pasta, but it's essential to keep the water from the pasta. You don't have to trash the water. Keep the water, please. Because it's very important for any kind of pasta. So we have the water here and the pasta here. here. The first thing is to put the guanciale in the pasta. The fire must be shut down. No fire. And then we put the egg. We need to put some water to make the pasta creamy. We add more cheese. And this is pasta alla carbonara. I hope you enjoyed the recipe. Thank you for watching and catch you on my next recipe. Bye bye. When the water is boiling, to put in the pasta.